Welcome to Code Black Facts, where we talk about all things black to include news and viral videos, mental health, self-love, self-care, self-development, black women issues, crime stories, and black history. On this channel, I encourage thinking and analyzing different concepts that may be difficult and are controversial concerning the black community. If you are interested in any of these topics, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and feel free to leave your comments below. Thank you. Okay, so Nick Cannon recently went viral because he thought it would be a good idea to make some type of like commercial promoting what appeared to be some type of reality show where he is so-called looking for his baby mama, right? And he's saying that Kevin Hart was going to be the host. Now, of course, that went viral because, again, this is Nick Cannon. Nick Cannon already has 12 children between six women. And he knew that it would, you know, go viral. He knew that it would get a lot of people's attention. But the reason why it's such a controversial topic is because you have some people that think, oh, well, he's making light of the situation. He's not a bad man. You know, he's actually there for his children, so on and so forth. But you have some people that are like, wait a minute, this is a real issue within the black community. Why would you make fun of that? Like, why would you make light of a real issue such as the baby mama, single parent, family homes, broken homes situation that the black community has? Not to mention, in the black community, black women are the highest, for being single mothers. And, you know, to make light of something like that, a lot of people did not think it was funny, and neither do I. Now, the way that I see this is that, you know, this is the image of a black man doing this. And we already know that there are several negative stereotypes within the black community of this particular situation, right? And my thing is, you have so many people that are like, oh, let's try to get away from this stereotype. You know, oh, those stereotypes are not true. But we say that we want to get away from, we want to separate from that. We, as in the black community, but more particularly black men, then why is Nick Cannon allowed to make fun of something that is a very real issue within the black community? It is an issue that is harming many, many, many families, many women, many communities. I mean, there is so much research out there about, you know, when children are growing up and they don't have their fathers, or their fathers are not present, or, you know, the women who are made baby mothers. You know, there's all types of research out there. And so, you know, for him to make light of that, or make fun of that, or make a joke about it, a lot of people just wasn't feeling it at all. But you guys know, on this channel, I do try to provide facts, right? So what I'm going to do is, we're going to talk about the negative stereotypes. So I'm actually going to put up, you know, somewhat of a chart, and then we're going to see how many negative stereotypes that Nick Cannon hit on, right? And then we're going to also go into the actual statistics, the numbers of, you know, within the black community of children who are in two-parent homes, single-parent homes, so on and so forth. All right. Okay. So first thing is first, I'm just going to name a few negative stereotypes. These are things that we call stereotypes. These are things that we, as the black community, say we don't like, we want to separate ourselves from. They're not true. Oh, it depends. This is what we're saying, right? And so I'm just going to name a few things, and then I'm going to compare that to what I think, or what technically Nick Cannon could be hitting on, right? So, you know, a stereotype towards the black community, more specifically black men: laziness, violent, aggressive, criminals, jobless, childlike, fatherless, animalistic, wild, and lack control, uneducated or slow, hypersexual, not civil, dishonest, physically strong, dangerous, angry, bad fathers, baby mama makers. All right. So those are just a few. There are many. Okay. There are many, because, I mean, there are things that get into how we look and things like that. But I didn't name those. So now, the ones out of the 18 that I named, the ones that Nick Cannon hit on, right? And this is the conversation. You guys get down in the comment section and tell me, you know, if he hits on these stereotypes. Because, again, he's perpetuating the very stereotypes that black men in particular say they don't want. They want to get away from. They don't want to be, you know, they don't want men representing them in that light. And for him to make light or make a joke about it, again, it's not cool. And many people are calling him out about this. But again, of course, this is up to each his own. So the stereotypes that I think that Nick Cannon hit on are, okay, so one might say that Nick Cannon is childlike. One might say that he is creating fatherless homes. One might say that he is acting animalistic, right? One might say that he is wild and lack control. One might say that he is uneducated or slow, meaning he doesn't understand the full grasp of what he's doing and how that could potentially be harmful for those children. One might say that he's hypersexual. One might say that what he's doing is not civil. One might say that, you know, he is dishonest, maybe about his true intentions. Who knows? One might say that, you know, he is a bad father. And of course, we all see that he is definitely creating baby mama. So he's a baby mama maker. So that's actually a little bit over 50% of just the ones that I named. And I wanted to create this because I want to paint a picture, right? I want to paint the picture because, again, the very negative stereotypes that black men get, right? These things go way, way back. And again, we've always said that, oh, well, it doesn't make it true. You know, stereotypes are not true, blah, blah, blah. But I mean, again, Nick Cannon is ultimately encompassing the very negative stereotypes that black men say that they want to get away from. All right. So that's just for something for you guys to think about. Let me know if you agree or disagree. Let me know if there are other stereotypes that he is perpetuating that were not named. And then let's move on to the actual statistics. All right. Okay, so as you guys can see from the chart that is on the screen, it basically breaks down, you know, the children by race in the homes that they grow up in. All right, so as follows, it says living arrangements of children under 18 by race and Hispanic origin 2020. And I actually got this from the U.S. Census Bureau. So this, you know, these are statistics that come from the government. Okay. So for black children, you have, so the light blue represents two parent family homes, married, you know, the parents are married. That is 37.9. The darker blue represents two parents, but the parents are not married. So technically that's a single parent home, okay? That's 3.4. And then you have the peach color that represents mother only. So that means the children grow up in, you know, in mother's only homes. And that represents 46.3. And then you have the green that represents father only, and that's 4.5. And then you have the clear, which represents no parent. So neither mom or dad. So if you add up the last three, that's going to be a little bit over 60%. All right. And that's actually, you know, down from what it used to be, because the last time I looked at these statistics, it was like something like over 75% of black children were growing up in single parent family homes. So that number has dropped, which is a good thing. But still, 60% or anything over 60% is still high, which makes it still an issue. And again, like I said, many people are just not feeling it. They don't think it's funny, especially for him to joke about, because he is, in fact, making baby mamas. He was only married to Mariah Carey. And after that, it's been a slew of baby mothers. And yes, you know, some people are making the argument, oh, well, you know, he has the money. He's taking care of his children. We don't know that. We don't know that because last we checked, wasn't it Mariah who came out and said that, you know, it has been a struggle because he has not been, you know, able to be there for the children that she has with him. So I would assume that, you know, of course, if it's a struggle for Mariah, mind you, Mariah, out of all of the baby mamas, she has the most, you know, financial stability to where, you know, she could send those kids probably on a flight every day to Nick. But obviously, Nick works a lot. So technically, I guess she wouldn't be able to do that because, I mean, what are you going to send them there and then they're just going to sit at the hotel by themselves? I mean, that's not spending time with their father. So, you know, a lot of people are saying, you know, you can't be there. You can't be in several different cities all at the same time. And then we don't know what the dynamic is with these mothers. Again, you know, an ideal situation would be that all the moms got along and they all, you know, would make sure that their children are hanging out. But I'm not getting that. More particularly from Mariah. I remember she did an interview one time where they asked her, and this is before he had so many baby mamas. I think at that time he had only had like three or something like that. And they asked her about, you know, the other women. And she's like, you know, she was like, no. Because they asked her about the step, would she consider his other children stepchildren or something like that? And she's like, no, he's not married. He's never, you know, she made some, I can't exactly remember what she stated, but basically she was saying, he's only been married once. Anything outside of marriage does not make stepchildren. That's basically what she was saying. All right, to sum it up. But anyways, that's all I have for you guys. Go ahead and get down in the comment section. Let me know your thoughts. And what do you think? What do you think about these statistics? What do you think about this whole thing? You know, is it something that, you know, he should joke about? Should he make light of it since, you know, that is his current situation? Or is it something that he should be taken seriously and that we all should be taken seriously? Because, again, this affects everybody. When you leave your home and you're black, everybody look at you like you're black. It's not like, oh, you know, we are all one big group. That's what it is. So anyways, and don't get me wrong by saying that we can set ourselves apart individually. I am a big believer in that. I don't believe that I am a representation of certain groups within the black community because I don't have certain issues that go on. However, I do know and understand that when I leave my house, I'm looked at as a black woman. So therefore, people may think that they can try me on certain things and certain negative stereotypes. So that's all I'm saying. But anyways, you guys be easy. I talk to you soon. Bye.